today we have got the fuse fire. So as you can see, we have this like see-through green tactical rail up here, which is the light up part. And as far as I'm concerned, it comes with 5 glow-in-the-dark vortex discs, same as the usual. And we have, Randy was there, and we have the pullback action here at the back if you want to see it. And for this gun you will need 3 AAA batteries, which are not included. So I think I've spoken enough about the outside, and let's get onto the inside. Oh, and as well, the other 2 Vortex Zombie Strikes are the Rip Shot and the Ricochet. So we have my very handy scissors. Yes. So this is quite, it's got quite nice colours to it. Here we have, instead of the green and black and grey, we have orange. So yeah, got the Zombie Strike emblem there, and pull back. Very easy to pull back, and you doesn't even make a sound when you do that. I think knows if it's been loaded. And yeah, that here we have 5 bullet holders, and in here you have to load from the back. Load from the back, and yeah, and I've just, it's got quite a nice like texture. If you can see there, it's got a texture, and that looks like the light switch is off on. So yeah, now let me just, here we've got our own little compartment thingy majiggy, and here are the vortexes. It comes with 5 glow in the dark, pretty cool. There you go. And also, if your bullet gets jammed after you load, there's a little button right there. If you push that forward, it should come out, but sometimes it doesn't. So yeah, can be a bit annoying sometimes, but yeah. Yes. Right, so here is the little compartment where you put your AAA. because we got two tape measures. It's going to be a bit harder. 29 feet isn't too bad. And through here we have two here. And check here, 16, so that those two are around 38 feet. And we have one here, and about 39 feet. And our final one is up here, which is approximately 46 feet. So that's okay. Now for the angled shots. Too bad. Shots aren't so accurate angled. Going to the right. Right, and that's it. Now let's take a look. Right, so as we come, right, first one here, which is about 42 feet, and as we come here we have our second one, which is about 44 feet, and we have two, which is 49 feet. And as we come up here we have our top one, which is 56 feet, which is pretty good. The leap is not bad considering leap guns go 75 feet. So altogether I think the fuse fire is a pretty cool gun. It's a nice weapon to have. Not sort of the outdoor Nerf war gun you would like to have, but indoors it's pretty cool, and accuracy is good but not angled. Just do not do angled shots, and it's a pretty nice gun. All together, I'm glad Nerf had done this. So guys, thanks for watching. Goodbye.